Welcome to the testing world. In previous session, we have seen how we can fetch header of response. Also, we have seen how we can fetch response code and response body. Now, I'm going to show you a few more methods which we can use to fetch different data in the response. So, first of all, I want to fetch content type. What do you mean by the content type? Okay, I'll show you. Here, I'm coming and clearing previous results. And now I'm coming to, okay, first of all, I want to execute and want to show you results. So that's my result. And it is failing just because in previous session I have added assertion. So as of now, I am just disabling bean shell assertion. And now I want to show you results. So here in the result, if you check in response, that is my content type. So I want to fetch my content type. In the same way, we have many methods. I want to fetch response body size. I want to fetch response header size. So I'll show you how we can do that. I'm just coming to the bean shell post processor. And we have seen previously, either we can put data into the log area or on the console. So what I'm going to do, I'm going to put here on the log area. So I'm just writing CTX, which is a JMeter context object. And now get previous result. It is going to give me object of sample result class. So these are the classes which exist in JMeter API. So I'm saying get previous result. Okay, pick the previous result and get content type. And as of now, I just want to display in the log. So I'm writing like log.info and content type. I'm just printing this, clear previous results, running it. So if I check it here, content type is this. So I fetch content type from the response. So we are fetching content type. Now I want to fetch response body size in bytes. So we have a method like, first of all, response body size, and I'm going to call a context object, get previous result dot get body size as long, and I'm just clearing result, running it. We are getting that's a content type and that's a response body size, which is 73. So that is response body size. In the same way, we can fetch response header size in bytes. So we have a same method. I'm just using same here, and get header size. Here we have method with the name get header size, and method name is get header size. So I'm just clearing previous result, running it. We check it. Header size is 540. So these are the method, like we can have multiple headers. So method name is get headers size. So now we have seen three methods: fetching content type, response body, and header size. Now we have many more methods, like we can fetch thread name. So I'm saying fetch thread name. And we can use all these details in assertions when we want to validate something. As of now, I'm just picking the data from the response and just displaying in the logs area. But normally we are using this data either for the validations. So we are going to use bean shell assertion, or we can store this data as a variable and we can use in the further step as an input. So it's up to us how we want to use it. So I'm saying, okay, get thread name, again clear previous results, run, And if you check it here, thread name is here, thread name, and I want to execute now. So my thread name is this. In the same way, I can fetch time taken by the sampler, and I can also fetch start time and end time. So what I'm doing here, first of all, start time of the sampler and end time of the sampler. Fetch time, and I'm saying first of all log.info, and then I want to fetch start time. So I'm saying start time and get start time. In the same way, I want to fetch end time. So I'm saying end time. And in the same way, I want to fetch time. So I'm saying get time. So, and after that also, I'm just putting this, and I'm saying total time taken by the sampler. So total time, clearing previous results, running it now. That's a start time, and it is giving you the date, time, date. It's a date, time, hours, seconds, milliseconds. So that is the time it is showing. And total time is taken. That's a starting time and that's the end time. If you calculate the difference between them, so it should be 560. So we're getting this 560 time taken. That's a start time, that's the end time, and that's the time taken by this sampler. In the same way, we have few more methods like get error count, get latency, fetch URL of the request. So if I want to fetch URL of the request, so I'm saying like, okay, I'm fetching URL. So which URL we are hitting? So I'm saying URL of this request against which we are getting this response. So it's a get URL as string. That's a method. And in the same way, I want to get error count. So how many errors we are having in the response? So I'm saying error count, and we are going to get error count. In the same way, I'm going to show you get latency. Latency. I'm just displaying latency here. Everything is done. I'm just clearing screen, running it again. That's a URL. Error count is zero. We are not having error in the response, and latency is this. So we have seen many methods which we can use while working on the response which we are getting from the server against any HTTP request. So I just copied this and pasted over here. So here we have seen a lot of methods which we can use with JMeter context object, and we are working on the response which we are getting. So we are fetching the different content of the response, and we can use this content in the assertion. So previously we have seen how we can make assertions on the data which we fetch from the response. So that's all we have for this session. Thanks for watching this video.